Well, hello there, all you absolutely magnificent people, and welcome back to another live stream of An Ecologist Plays, where we are back in Enshrouded. And as always, we are joined by Nick the Beast.
Ahoy!
Where are you, dear?
Oh, I'm at our new house.
Oh, at a new house. Okay, yeah. Okay, cool beans. Alright, so I did see there was a quest from the bard, but I think it was only with my other character that I was running around here that it or she had a quest for me. Alright, so let's head back actually. In a moment. I am actually busy just quickly getting the last few health potions done. I think I can make 3 more, just so that we've got, or 4 more, right? Yay. Just so that we have some health potions for the evening. Right, then, what do I need to drop? A whole bunch of stuff. Okay, so there have been some progress regarding where we are building now, our PETRA that we are building. And I am very, very keen to show that to you. So hopefully, I do believe I am basically off. Okay, so let's head up there first, show you what's happening there. And then we can come back and I can craft my new spells. Because, oh yes, I'm going to have some eternal spells crafted as well in a moment. Alrighty. So, here we are in our PETRA base. So this is our base in the limestone that we are building here. So not true like PETRA. PETRA is in sandstone, but we are building our PETRA-like base over here. And as you can see, we've been excavating a bit. We've been building in stairs. We've got a little room over here. We still have to make it very nice. This is just the basic, the crudeness thereof.
Yes.
There's a little window. You can kind of see the light outside.
We haven't decorated at all yet.
No, there's no decorations yet. Nick has crafted a whole bunch of decorations, but they are currently
starting
in storage.
Yeah, I only started now for a little bit. That's why I was missing for a bit.
Okay, cool. Yeah, so this is another little room we've got upstairs here. We're still going to really build a lot. This is our bedroom, hey dear?
Yes.
Yeah, so this is our bedroom. Oh, wow, nice. Yeah, this is looking nice. So you can see all these little floaty white luminescent blocks, they are there just so I can see what on earth I was actually excavating. All right, and then if we go down here, then this is just basically the smithing area thus far, at least. Okay, now what I need to do is actually get the bronze bars going. That's what I need to do. We do need a whole bunch of copper bars for that, though. I don't think we've got any copper bars in storage here. Oh, we do. A whole bunch of right over here. All right. Just want to get that started for us so long, because I will need 3 copper bars in a moment. Of course, bronze bars. Bronze, of course, made by smelting tin and copper together. That gives you bronze. All right. And a whole little tunnel also excavated. This was just to see how far we could go before we ran out of space.
I just got level 15.
Oh, nice. Okay, just from the location discovered at the end of this tunnel. The Flame Sanctum. And then, well, this of course being the entrance. And then on the sides here, I'm busy building statues. 2 different ways. This way I am using limestone blocks, just kind of stacking it all up to make kind of like a little statue. And here is a much more laborious task. This is where I am placing down limestone blocks and then excavating it 1 block at a time. Kind of like the statues in Lord of the Rings, you know, along the river. I think the Argonauts it's called. Kind of like that, but yeah. All right. I also have to say, if I at some point start coughing or talk a bunch of nonsense, that is because I am actually sick at the moment, but I'm here just to have a bit of fun with you guys as well. All right. You are still decorating. Hey, dear.
Oh, yeah, until you tell me we need to go.
Okay, I'm going to go back to our base because I'm going to get us 2 instruments.
Oh, cool.
Because we do now have a magic sheet, so we can now actually play some music.
Oh, yes.
Yes. Nice. So, let me actually, I'm not sure whether I actually picked up that music sheet as well. And picking it up, well, I do believe I had. Picking it up will give you of daggers and wine. Okay, so you said you want the what instrument?
I want the drum.
You want the drums. Okay, I don't know whether we've got the hand drum yet. We don't have the hand drum yet.
Oh, yes, there was a little guitar thingy that I...
Yes, the lute. Okay, so you want the lute. I'm going to go with the harp, I think. Yes, I think I'm going to go with the harp. Alrighty. And then to craft my new spells. The spells, the lovely, lovely spells. Let's see here. Balthazar. We get no other quests for us. Okay, Balthazar, I want some spells here. I want the Eternal Chain Heal. Oh, I need the Antiseptic. I think that is done by now. And then for this one, I just need Bronze Bars. Now, the Bronze Bars are currently busy there where Nick is. And in a few minutes, that will be done. But I do believe I've got enough Antiseptic here. Yes, indeed, I do. Okay. And that gives us the cleaned bandage. Oh, the cleaned bandage is very nice, because that will actually give us the ability to heal poison. So if we get poisoned by the matriarchs, or by the matrons, not matriarchs, by the matrons, then, well, we can actually cure that poison on us. Ah, eternal chain heal. There we go. That is absolutely lovely. Okay, so now I can get rid of these chain heals here, because I've got the eternal version. Drop that in there. And there we go. I've got my eternal. Oh, that's awesome. That is so much fun. All right. So I hope you all are having a lovely, lovely weekend. We've got a long weekend, which is amazing. Yeah. So just want to quickly check.
You have here. A nice long weekend.
Yes, I've got a long weekend. I do have a long weekend, which is absolutely marvelous. Let's just see here. Where is?
Let's see where you are. Our base. I think I should decorate off screen later, because I just go into this rabbit hole.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll be with you in a moment, dear.
We had a very nice Friday, didn't we?
Oh, yes. We had a bit of an excavation. I don't know why I said excavation. An expedition. We had an expedition to the beach, because it is currently the southern, or the great southern bioblitz, which is attempting to record as many species as possible over this weekend from Friday to Sunday. So up until basically this evening at midnight. And we went to the beach. We went to, with my students, with my first year students, we went to the beach. We saw a whole bunch of interesting things, interesting plants, interesting animals, including octopus, which is always fun to see as well. I see President is also in the chat. Hello there, President.
Hey, President.
We are doing very well. Hope you are doing well as well on that side. Well, it seems. Speaking of well, we need to make a well. Okay, and to make a well, we need linen and we need the wooden buckets. I think we're going to craft two wells for that. So the buckets, all we need are the metal sheets. I'll go grab two of those
as well.
Where do
we get the Blackmire Heartwood?
The what? The?
Blackmire Heartwood.
Oh, we will have to go chop down trees in the Blackmire Marshes, I believe, then. We need to go there in any case to go kill some crocodiles.
Yes.
So we are going to do that. So that's a good plan. What do we make with that, dear?
A very nice rustic banquet table.
Oh, nice. Okay, now we have to go do that then. So I guess what we are going to do first, though, is I'm going to grab the linen, which is over here. There we go. I think we can use all the linen there. And grab that. And then we can make two wells somewhere higher up. Where are the wells? Wells. There we go. And there we go. Two wells we have made now. So we can drop that down at our new base as well.
Yeah, I also need to drop some stuff off.
Okay, I just need to check the flax. Okay, I've got a whole bunch of flax I can also dump in here to get the hand spindle going so long.
Next time I'll also start moving some of this house's stuff. But yes. You need to finish building, because I can't really decorate if I don't have a finished product.
That's true. No, we'll definitely do that. Did you teleport again?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Let me just check whether I've got anything else. No, nothing else I need. So let's head off then. Let me see. I'll come and join you up here. Today's mission, it's going to be a shorter stream because of me being kind of sick at the moment still. I'll be able to do a 2-hour stream and then I need to go sleep, I think. So what we are going to do is we're going to do a bunch of stuff. Let me just send Nick her loot.
Oh, arigato.
You're most welcome. So if we look at our quests here, we technically have the quest for the hand drum for the bard, dear, which is in the treetop Vukah settlement. So that is in the Blackmire Marshes. So we need to go there in any case.
Okay, cool.
We also have in need of a tanning station. If we can get the tanning station, that'll be great as well, because then we can actually tan hides and make leather, awesome. Which is also necessary.
Yes.
So for that, we are going to have to take out the matron at Lupa's lair.
Ooh.
Which is, we're going to use our shroud and our explosive arrows again, because that worked very well last time.
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay, you're ready.
I've got them on me, yeah.
Before we head out, we may as well first place down our wells and then actually also play some music.
Yes.
Because, I'm going to place this down right over here. The two wells. Ah, yeah, you are playing.
Yeah, look at me.
But let me join you as well. Of daggers and wine.
currently playing Pike Meets Peak.
Oh, I see. Interesting. Okay, anyway, so there we go. We're playing a song. Of course, that gives us 2 extra minutes to the rested buff. Alrighty.
Okay, so we're going up. It's actually nice, these two instruments together.
Yes, indeed, the two string instruments. I do love it. I've always loved a harp. And the lute, I think, is also so nice. Such a medieval weapon. Instrument. Blackmire. I'm sure, you know, if you wanted to, you could bash someone over the head with a lute. Although you would lose your lute in the process.
Okay. Blackmire fast travel, eh?
Sorry?
Blackmire fast travel.
Yes, let's head out that direction. Because the hand drum is over there. Daggers for the bard is over there as well. And, of course, the crocodiles, the croconosters, are also there. We need to go take them out for the hide as well. Ooh, how many? Now I do have the fireball spell.
How many do we need to kill?
I think we need 12 hide. 12 reptile hide. For the medium... Okay. Medium...
We'll see how many one drops.
Yes, we'll see. Actually, there is, on the way to the Vukah treetops, we are going to... plop down over here. Because there's a daggers. The bard's daggers are also over here somewhere. You are behind me, hey?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. We're just heading out. It's about 120 meters, 100 meters, 90 there's meters. Oh, will you look at that? We are at the Snapjaw Tar Pits. Oh, there's an obelisk.
Yeah.
May as well go for that first. Cool. Let's read. The wild spirit of the Blackmire remains untamed. Winding roots entangle us, twist around all efforts of our kin. Everything fades into the sounds of the night, a symphony of sweet and somber melodies. We drown in them like bugs in the black water bog, dragged below by the vines. Such unbound energy, shining bright like the stars. Okay. Now, somewhere around here, I believe, the daggers should be. I'm wondering whether it isn't perhaps below us. Oh, okay, not what I wanted to do.
Oh, I did it too. Oh no, I'm going down.
Yeah, I'm also down, and oh look, there's the there are the daggers right over here. In a dead crocodile, dead reptile. Okay, so there is a crocodile here, and I think it is aggressive, at least thus
far. For you.
Sorry?
It was maybe for you, yeah.
Yes, to me it was definitely. Now I want to see where it is so I can cast fireball at it.
There it is.
Ah, poo. There we go. Hello there.
You just made it angry.
I did, didn't I? Okay, so it's going to pop out. And now we just have to keep in mind that we are going to sink into the mud. We have to... Oh, hello there. We shouldn't stay in the tar for too long. I call it tar, but it seems this is actually more mud than tar. And it is dead. Okay. Oh, wow, got 5 reptile hide there.
Oh, cool.
That is great.
We need three.
Sorry?
We just need to kill 3 then.
Yes. And thanks, President. I believe I will be well very soon. I'm drinking everything I can, including the most horrible, foul-tasting herbs.
Bitter as hell. It's a South African herb. It's named Sutherlandia.
Yes.
Or cancer bush.
Yes. Not that it will give you cancer, but it is sometimes used as a cure for cancer, or a treatment for cancer. Not a cure, a treatment for cancer. It is horrible.
Where does this thing take us?
It takes you up here, where I am. At the moment, actually. Other side, to behind you.
Oh.
Hello. And then I think from here, we go in here. I don't know where it takes us then, but it takes us in here. Huh. I don't think I've ever been in this specific cave. Always nice to wander around a bit.
So, President, how was your week?
Yes, how was your week? Did you have a fun week? What did you do? Busy with work, I assume?
Yeah, how is the job going?
Yeah, last time we chatted, you were doing well. It was a new environment to get used to. I think you'll get Blackmire hardwood from this tree, dear.
Is it?
Yeah. So I'll just drop it down to see what we can get from it. And of course it is night. Ooh, we've got wood here. Just normal hardwood?
Just normal hardwood.
Ah. Okay. Still just normal hardwood. Of course, now it is nighttime. Why is it always nighttime?
What's there by that light?
Those lights are also the bouncy bouncies.
No, they're over at yonder.
Oh, we can go have a look. I just... Yeah, it's just a boat. Oh, this
There's
is something
to
read.
Yeah.
Something to read here. Let's see. This is... Oh, excerpts from Val's Valiant Tales. So, a sticky situation. We're not under attack by the crocodile, are we?
Mm-mm.
No. Okay. So Val says, I'm jotting this down with a racing heart. If anyone finds this, read my tale to your young in front of the fireplace and toast to my health and valor. I paddled through the cliffs of a rocky valley, quietly humming a tune when I saw bubbles emerge from below the muddy water's surface. At first, I thought it might be a sign of a sunken riches. Perhaps one of the capsized boats near me had carried immeasurable treasures. Unfortunately, I was quickly proven wrong. A terrifying snap jaw. So that's the name of the crocodiles that we've got right behind me here. The snap jaws. A terrifying snap jaw suddenly lunged at my visage, or visage, undoubtedly summoned by my lovely voice. Built like a true wyvern, a dragon even, with shimmering back dark as night. It sunk its teeth into my boat, so I thrust my daggers into its neck. I escaped unharmed, but my dagger is lost, and without my old boots, I'll get stuck in the mud if I try to retrieve it. Ah, what a sticky situation. Literally. Okay, so that's just how Valerie the Bard lost her daggers. Okay, a little bit difficult to actually fight.
In the dark, yeah.
In the dark.
Let me use my Wisp of Light.
Yes, that's a great plan, dear. Thanks.
My last one.
Okay, it's going to emerge again soon. Of course, it is very capable of running through the mud here. And not getting stuck like I am at the moment. Okay, I just need to come out. There we go. Yay.
Nice. I didn't really contribute there.
That's all right. It's almost dead. You are the light in my life, dear. Oh, where is it? Oh, there he is. Hold on.
I contributed.
Yes. Okay, I am floating on its back. There we go. 4 more hide. So nice. Now we've got 9. We need 3 more.
Cool.
Yes.
This is our last victim.
Oh, yes, I see. Just going to wait for him to emerge. Oh, wow. Okay, it's resisted. Interesting. Ivo, where are you? There he is. Okay, out of the water, out of the mud. It really is at home in the water, so we need to do everything we can to stay out of its way while it is in the water. Okay, so very, very hard, scaly, well, leather, basically. Very well armored. Kind of reminds me of a thorny devil, which is a type of reptile you can find. Yeah, Thorny Devil of Australia. They are quite cool. I was thinking of between the Thorny Devil and the Horny Toad. Horny Toad is a reptile, not a toad, actually, but from America, as far as I recall, whereas the Thorny Devil is a very similar-looking reptile from Australia. And there we go. We actually got 3 hide from that as well. So we have 12, which is exactly what we needed.
Okay, oh, so I see. President just got back from a team-building party.
Oh, nice.
That's nice.
That's cool.
Yeah. Okay. Always fun. Look how this thing is... giving off spores.
Oh, wow. That is true. It does seem to be technically dispersing either pollen
or
spores,
yeah,
or seeds or something. Very, very interesting. I wonder whether it was whether it is doing this in order to actually have pollination at night.
Mm.
Most likely. I would imagine because it is luminescent. I mean,
yeah,
it is glowy.
So it's probably a night flower.
Yes, it probably does attract a whole bunch of moths. The moths come flying around here. I mean, judging from the size of the wasps we have in this game here, moths could also be very, very big. So yeah, it most likely attracts moths. Also, possibly has wind pollination. I mean, there are lots of little pollen grains floating into the air, and if there's any wind blowing, it will also be blown around. Speaking of which, I believe wind is something that they are planning to add with the next update, which is going to be awesome. When that drops. Okay, whereabouts are you, dear?
Right behind you.
Okay.
I sent you a ping. Are we going there?
Oh, you sent me a ping. I was wondering what sound I was hearing. Yes, a little bit to the north of that. There are the two question marks there. So, yes, we are heading in that direction. Because the idea now is hopefully it becomes daytime soon. But we are heading over to that side. So, okay, I'm just dropping down. Taking a quick nap between... Oh, dropping down even further. Really not great to run around at night. Why do we like doing it so?
Just makes it more interesting.
Sorry?
Makes it more interesting.
Hello.
Hello, piggies.
Hello, piggies. Don't mind us. I'm just going to chop down some more trees. Hopefully one of these will give us Blackmire Hardwood. Really hoping it does. These are just normal hardwood. Okay, so if anybody knows where we can get Blackmire Hardwood, that'll be great. We'd really appreciate that. Thus far, we only have normal normal hardwood.
Yeah.
Yeah, still normal hardwood.
Even this big one, eh?
As far as I know, I'll just come and help as well. So I don't think we get Blackmire Hardwood from this. That looks like normal hardwood. Mm. Yep, indeed. Okay, anyway, let's head out, shall we? About 170 meters to run. Okay.
I'm sure we'll see that tree looks different. We'll know when we see it.
Yeah, I mean, there are these massive trees, so maybe it's one of those. I don't know. Now, location above. Luckily, with the Vukah being friendly towards us, we can just run in here and get our things.
Mm.
We don't have to worry about dying to them. And with the beasts not attacking us, we don't even have to worry about the snapjaws in here either. Hello, Vukah friends. Ah, this is awesome. I love the fact that we can run amongst them. No problems. We don't even have to worry about our weapons degrading because it's not like we're going to use it.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, that's a trap. I found a trap for us.
Always.
Always, yes, of course. Okay, there's a snapjaw below us. Oh, I think there is a place to... Yeah, there we go, a grapple point up here. I heard a peacock there. Did you also hear it?
Yeah, it sound, I could hear it, yeah.
The caw!
Yeah.
That's a peacock sound right there. Okay, there's a beam to walk across. And the lattice work to climb up against. This is much nicer, but I guess less exciting doing it this way.
Yeah.
There's a silver chest. I'm getting distracted, but I fell down completely.
Oh, me too.
We are completely down.
Yeah.
This is the problem with doing it at night, eh? Horrible idea.
Now I'm kind of stuck here.
I see you. Wait, where are you? Oh.
I'm stuck here in the corner.
Let me see. Hello there, dear. I will come and chop this thing. There we go. I rescued you.
Thank you.
Hello there, dear. Okay, let's try that again, shall we?
So they say we must do it with the pickaxe, those big trees.
Oh,
I've never gotten...
Oh, that's Blackmire...
That's Blackmire Bark.
Bark. And hello there, it's Haroon.
Maybe.
And JF Devoy. Welcome to the stream, guys.
Hey, it's Haroon, JF Devoy. So, maybe we... No, we can't make it from... We can't...
Oh, I found the trap again.
We can't use the bark and make the wood, right?
Are you sure it was Blackmire Hardwood and not
yes.
Blackmire Bark?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Heart is hardwood, like heartwood.
Heartwood.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe we need to mine in through the bark, because heartwood refers to the inside of the tree. So that makes sense then. I was thinking hardwood, but heartwood makes sense then. That you would get it by mining in through the bark of the tree. Okay, so we'll have to do that. Thanks then.
We'll have
and
to
hello
check.
There, Tommy X as well.
Hey,
welcome,
Tommy
welcome.
X.
Everybody in
up
the
here.
House. Well, 9 people in the house. Goodness me.
All of a sudden.
Glad to have you all here with us on this lovely, lovely Sunday evening as we again. Now, this time around, I'm not going to be distracted by that lovely silver chest over there.
It's probably... Is it a silver chest?
It's a silver chest there.
Oh.
Look, it's glowy. I'm not going to go for it. Do you want to go for it?
No.
I'm going to go for it. See, this time around I get... okay, I hit the beam above me.
But you can go up.
But I'm basically there.
Awesome.
Let's see, what do we get? A wolf's maw and archer boots. Wow.
Wow.
Oh, there's actually a swinging spot, actually. There's a place, a grapple to swing from.
Must I go there?
No, it's all right. I'm coming back up. I'm basically at where you are now. It's not too far from where you are. Okay, great. Comes from the core of the trees, says JF DeVoy.
My goodness. And I've mined that bar quite deep once.
Yes.
But maybe you should be like at the stump. I was like on a branch.
Yes.
That's interesting.
I see you down there.
Oh.
It should be almost daytime.
Oh, the hell did you get up there?
I don't. Over here.
Oh.
Magic. That's how I got up here. Magic. A lot of magic. Now, I don't think this is... Oh, maybe it is the right place, because I see light up ahead. No, it is a horrible plant. A few of these horrible plants. I'm just checking to see whether there's anything else, but I don't see anything else.
Ah, I'm a cool copy.
Oh, you're a cool copy. Oh, shame, I see. Okay, maybe we actually are at the wrong place now. You know, that's the problem with nighttime. Nighttime explorations are bad times.
Okay, so do you want to mine in the end to see if we can find that heartwood?
Yes, let's climb to the top of this branch here. I don't think we can make it to the top, though. No. This is a bad idea. Let's wait for daytime. Before we do such things. Okay, I am also trapped. Should be daytime soon. I'm hoping it is, because my torch is basically also kaput. And where are we? Are we... And there we go, day breaks, finally. Okay, now we can see. Okay, not that it helps me, because I don't know where we are, but I guess upwards is the name of the game. Hello there, Bat. Don't mind us, Batty.
I'm gonna become a Vukah.
Yes. I think this is the way. This is the way. I believe
there's something to read, eh?
Oh, is there? Oh. Ooh, let's come back. I missed that completely. Thanks, dear.
Pleasure.
Don't run too far, because the beasties will attack me. So, revel word, hidden crafting recipes. Oh, it's a hidden crafting recipe. That's nice. So I have to get away before they catch me, but I lose my thoughts all the time. They fly from my head into the night. I will forget, but I can't forget this thing, so I have to write it down quickly. The cave behind us collapsed. I remember the rubble and dust, the stones hailing down, the pain, the headache, and the beasts took me from my brothers at night when the moon was full. But this thing will help us get back home, will help me escape. If I remember how the Vukah made it, I can make it too. I saw the Vukah make it from between the bars. That's right, I was in a cage, because they dragged me here at night, when the moon was full, or crescent, maybe? I hit my head, I think. The stones hit my head, and now I am here. I forget why. I have to get away before they catch me. Okay, so some crafting recipe. Yeah, not that I'm sure where it is. But anyway, I think we've got to head up this way, dear. Because I think there is a repair tool up here.
We didn't even use our...
Sorry?
We didn't even use our weapons.
No, but my torch needs to be repaired. I think this is a piece of amber. Oh, there's a piece of meat. That's not a piece of amber lying there. It looked like amber. I've been mining amber a lot today. So I think I mined like 200 amber in
one
go.
Excuse me, sir.
All right, here we go. Now I can use my light again. My torch. All righty.